I could speak all afternoon about the person that I am standing on this stage with. Today we take the next step, thank you, Joe, forward in our fight.
Thank you, Joe. 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 Thank you, Joe.
So, we here, we believe deeply. Every senior in our nation should be able to live with security, stability, and dignity. And so in the United States of America, no senior should have to choose between either filling their prescription or paying their rent. That's the subject of today. Because we know for far too long, far too many of our seniors have struggled to afford their medication. And as a result, seniors have been forced to spend their time trying to figure out how they are going to be able to fill a prescription like insulin, based on the doctor's prescription, which is about saving their life, or whether they'd have to ration their pills to be able to make it stretch through a month. As a United States Senator, I fought to pass laws that would make healthcare more affordable and accessible for all Americans. And as Vice President, together with Joe Biden, our President, we finally addressed the long-standing issue that for years was one of the biggest challenges on this subject, which was that Medicare was prohibited by law from negotiating lower drug prices. And those costs then got passed on to our seniors, but not anymore. 2 years ago, as Vice President, I was proud to cast the tie-breaking vote that sent the bill. That gave Medicare the power to negotiate and let it get to the president's desk. And I was proud when our president, Joe Biden, signed that bill into law. In the 2 years since, we've been using this new power to lower the price of life-saving medications, and now to announce the result of those negotiations. It is my eternal and great, great, great honor, I have to tell you, to serve with this most extraordinary human being and American and leader, our President Joe Biden.
Thank you, Kamala. Well, I love you guys, too. I've been waiting for this moment for a long, long time. First time I sponsored a bill to let Medicare negotiate the price of drugs was in 1973 as a freshman senator with a guy named Frank Church from the state of Idaho. Folks, I have an incredible partner. The progress we've made, she's going to make one hell of a president. And Judy, thank you for sharing your story. It's another one for far too many Americans. People like my dad used to lay in bed at night when they lost his insurance as the company he worked for, staring at the ceiling, literally. And you've all experienced, you know, people who have experienced this, wondering what in God's name happened if my wife gets breast cancer, or if I get sick, or my children get seriously ill. What happens? What in God's name? How can we pay for the drugs, prescription drugs? I'm serious. These are the discussions. You know it. Do we have enough insurance? Can we afford the medical bills? We'll have to sell the house to get a second mortgage. There are discussions that took place in my house and your house. Kamala and I both get it. We know it isn't just about health care. It's about your dignity. No, it's about your dignity. It's about peace of mind. It's about security. It's about taking care of your family. It's about giving folks just a little bit more breathing room. That's all. Look, I believe that health care should be a right, not a privilege in America. This is a fight all of us have been fighting for a long time, taking on Big Pharma. We pay more for prescription drugs. It's not hyperbole. We pay more for prescription drugs than any advanced nation in the world. I could take you out on Air Force One, and if you have a prescription from a drug company in America, and fly you to Toronto, Canada, fly you to Paris, France, fly you to Belfast, anywhere around the world, and get you the same prescription filled from the same company for 40% to 60% less than we pay for it here. Too many Americans can't afford the drugs they badly need for life and death. So they skip doses, cut pills in half, forego prescriptions entirely because the prescription drugs are totally unaffordable. The woman the nurse you just met, she's paying $900 a month. Well, guess what, man? She's going to pay nowhere near that. $9,000. She's going to pay, guess what? Beginning January, every single prescription drug she has, including, God forbid, if she needs a really expensive drug like a cancer drug. Maximum she ever has to pay is $2,000, period. We'll take the insulin needed to treat diabetes. The guy who invented that insulin 100 years ago didn't put a patent on because he wanted it to be available for everybody. He didn't even patent it. Well, guess you know how much it cost those companies to make that insulin? $10, T-E-N. That's the God's truth. $10, number one. Number two, to package it and ship it, you might get it up to $13. But they were charging up to $400 a month for it. But now they can't charge more than $35 a month. Last summer, I announced under that law, Medicare is going to select, and it's already passed the law, 10 drugs a year, going up to 20 till we get every single drug every year. Drugs treat from everything from heart failure, blood clots, kidney disease, arthritis, blood cancers, and more. And today, I'm proud to announce that Medicare has reached agreement with all manufacturers on all 10 drugs selected in the first round of negotiations. The new prices for all 10 drugs will go into effect in January of 2026. Not this January, next January. Negotiations cut the price of these 10 drugs for Judy and others who are Medicare nearly 40% to 80%, depending which drug it is. Let me give you one example. Non-insulin diabetes drugs cost $530 a month. Some of you may know that. Guess what? It's now only going to cost $115. By the way, these new prices on 10 drugs would cumulatively mean $1.5 billion less out of pocket for patients to the drug companies. Lower copays for many of the 9 million seniors who take these drugs. But that's not all. We're also saving the American taxpayer because of the new changes, $6 billion a year, because Medicare won't have to pay out that much. Imagine that. $6 billion a year. Well, let me close with this. It's all about health care. It's about lowering costs for families. It's about fairness and security. It's about the dignity for people like Judy and millions of Americans all across the country. That's exactly what we're doing. There's more we can do for everyone. We can't give up. They told me every major piece of legislation we passed to give us the strongest economy in history and the strongest economy in the world. We got more to do for working people. By the way, everybody does better when there's more unions. But we're finally getting it done. We can't stop now. We just have to remember who in the hell we are. We're the United States of America. And there is nothing, nothing beyond our capacity in this country to work together. Nothing, nothing, nothing. I'll tell you what, I thank God that in the last 3 months I'm President of the United States, I was able to finally get done what I tried to get done when I was a young senator, 30 years old. Thank you, God. Thank you. God bless you all, and may God protect our troops. Thank you.